Gina.
Because everybody I meet in the hotel says, who are you guys? We haven't found people that actually care about each other like you guys do. That look at each other. Yeah. That really care.
That's right.
Right here. Because Mike said something this morning that's absolutely critical. We are authentic. We don't need to teach you how to have a pitch, do we? We want you to open up your hearts. As people, we love people. In fact, if you go back, and you know I always like to go back to see how we were programmed initially to find out why we're so screwed up today. One of the areas is that we hung out together, man. We got by the fire at night and we, oh man, did you see that big old saber-toothed tiger I killed? And your wife was going, but we loved each other and we cared for you. We knew it was important. It is built into our hormonal balance. It is part of us. We are compassionate, and unfortunately, we forgot to put that into the software of modern technology. So what we're going to do this morning is, I know, I've watched you, I know and I feel and I love you guys. I mean, I tell you that other than my family, this is the coolest bunch of people in the world.
Thank you. Love you too. Woo!
And Mike said we have a mission, we are mission driven, and that can come, you know, in the trilogy. When I created the trilogy, is about being fueled. It can be fueled by your spirituality, it can be fueled by your mission. Whatever it is, the components are pretty cool and they're essential to living well-being. But for you to truly live well-being, we need to take those ideas, that amazing feeling you're having right now, and we need to translate it into action, right?
Yeah.
Because what I don't want is you sitting in this seat clapping for the next 10 years and looking as you see people around you. It's kind of like in the, you know, down at the shore at the carnival, you roll the balls up and the horses go forward.
Yeah.
Everybody
yeah.
saw that before?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I'm talking about. You're rolling the balls and you're rolling, then you realize it's not just precisely getting that one and rolling it like this, and getting it perfect, right? It's about starting to do it as fast as you can, right? Move, and that's who wins the race. So for those of you that keep it in the theory and love the warmy, gooey feeling we're having, you're gonna be sitting in that seat going like, and right now it's, and about 10 years from now it's gonna be. Honey, I'm going to go one more time and give it one more try. Some of you laughing, some of you going, your voice, your devil in your head just said, yep, let's go to the bar right now. And that is not going to get you there. So I talked on Thursday night about taking the stairs. And I mean that, obviously, literally, because if you take the stairs, your energy expenditure, you know your need points go up, and it's much more productive, and you get there probably faster, and you feel better because you're moving your blood around during your workday. All those are good, but I'm talking about metaphorically that by taking the stairs means that in every action that you do on Monday, and I love what Mike finished with, if you do the actions, you will get the results. If you don't do the actions, you can be perfect, but you're not going to build a business, and you're not going to do the one thing that you said. Do you guys want to get America and then the world healthy?
Yeah.
Okay. That doesn't happen in theory. This is not a spectator sport. This is an action sport, one where action comes first. Throwing the balls, discipline, more balls, more balls, more balls, because you're not going to get out and meet enough people if you focus on one person. Ooh, I found this perfect person. This person's going to make my business so good. Why don't you just get the yellow pill or the blue pill like an Alice and go to Wonderland? Because it ain't going to happen.
Right.
It's not going to happen. So, I can't tell you how excited this is. I'm more excited about talking to you right now than I ever did. Because you know what I've got now? I have an amazing corporate partners. We as field leaders have amazing partners that have created what Dan started talking about. Duplication. We have duplication. So that five levels down from you, or five people that see this brochure sitting where can read it and say, oh my goodness, this is what I've been looking for. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to talk about that this morning. Now, I want to pull one quote out of here, because what I'm talking about this morning is the role of a business coach. And the role of a business coach is about personal transformation. It's about empowering your new coaches. And the job changes. You know, Lori talked yesterday about the role of a health coach, which is to help clients move forward. But when you become a business coach, it's kind of like birthing. It's like having a baby, right? Now, how many girls in here have had babies? Raise your hand. There's a lot of work involved in that, right? And you have to get good, and maybe the first time you don't put the diapers. Now, you guys, you never get the diapers right. In fact, I always had juice spilling out the back. But the point is, how do you get to be good at it? You do it, right? You do it. Well, in here, there's a great section called the Take Shape for Life Mindset. And by the way, all this is the distillation of the field leadership working together with the company to take our DNA and make it real. So it's written down. It's kind of like in that movie, one of the Road Warriors, Mel Gibson movies, where all the kids are on the plane and they got the story all wrong. Do you remember that?
Yeah,
one person. You guys gotta get out of here. But anyway, the point is, now it's duplicable. It's here, and they say something here, and this is what I want to talk about for the next 5 or 10 minutes. Becoming your own company CEO is one of the best paths available to an entrepreneur, like any worthy endeavor, to successfully depend on your efforts. Discipline. Take the stairs. This is my translation. Be prepared to make a genuine effort towards your business, and you will be rewarded. So, not a genuine effort. This is not like, yo, to try, right? Do! You gotta do! Okay? This might mean that you must create new habits. You know I like habits. And new disciplines. Take the stairs to support your new business. So what I want to do is just spend a moment and talk about some of the key components of that. As a guide, you're going to help your coach, your new coach, not just build a business, but you're going to be there to help them improve their physical health, right? You're their health coach. You get paid for doing that, don't you?
Right, yeah. Mm-hmm.
You get paid quite a bit, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, percentage-wise, you get paid the most. Now, as Dan talked about, we're going to talk about duplicating that so it exponentially grows, so it leverages your time and money. But in the beginning, you want to do a good job, because if they don't embrace totally and they start failing and going backwards on the program, and they're not getting healthy, then most likely they're probably not going to continue as a coach. Because the habits of health are not just the physical habits, they're the habits of a healthy business. And I got to say, key in there is the mental transformation. You are going to change. And then, of course, the financial transformation, which Dan did a great job, and Lori's going to talk about, and Terry's going to talk about in a little bit. But what I'm going to talk about are some key components. Let's move these forward. First is visioneering. If your new coach doesn't have a good idea of where they're going, are they going to get there? So they need to take aim. And visionary, I love this term. I found this term reading a book a few months ago. Because vision is a great, but it's an idea. It's a visual idea. It is a something that's your North Star that you can move towards, but you actually have to move. It's like in Madagascar. What did they say? You got to
move it.
Yeah, you got to move it. So the idea is to take this idea and move it into action, because it's not going to happen if you sit around and think about it. And you got to start. Listen, you got to start. This is about starting. You don't have to be perfect. Just do your best and forget the rest. It doesn't matter. But if you don't start, and you don't have to be 100% prepared. Perfectionism is a fault. It is not a good thing. Start right away. Sit down and start your new coach. It's like, what did they do to Maverick after Goose died? Getting back in the plane, right? As soon as that person signed up, you don't want to give them time to have buyer's remorse, like, oh my goodness, I love the idea, I'm going to be a coach. Because you know what? It's not about this idea, it's about this doing, right? So get them moving. Oh, wait, I'm going to go back. Okay. Do not stop. Once you start your new coach, and you birth your new coach, get them into momentum. Get them moving. Do not let them stop. When they say, well, I'm going to do it next Sunday, and maybe the next Saturday after that, that doesn't work. Even if they could only give half an hour a day, hold up their vision of why they're doing this, their purpose. By the way, can I ask you guys something? Is this vision, what Mike talked about, is this vision of what we want to do to create a healthy world, the vision that allows you to see the things that have happened in front of you, see too much now, is that vision big enough to fill you up?
Yes.
Is that big enough to really get behind?
Yes. Yes.
Then decide. I don't want you guys being shitheads. I want you to say, I've decided, now how? How do I become successful? That's what vision really is about. And start and keep your new coach going. Keep them moving. You got to keep them moving. Knock down. They're going to have disappointments. But if you've now inspired them around their vision and you're there with them and you're there by their hand, you know, the first time your child got on a bike, they probably fell down and skinned their knees, right? Or hurt themselves. And I gotta tell you, motivation, if you're a little kid, you skin your knee when you get on the bike, you probably think, hey, I'm not getting back on that bike. But what do? You're there for them and you encourage them and you maybe you hold them. Maybe you do something as easy as putting training wheels, which is what our system does. It gives your new coach training wheels, right? Gives them a system to follow. Stop trying to do it on your own by yourself. Use the system. But basically, once they're riding, they get the momentum. When you're going, you can keep going, right? But you are going to get knocked down. But if you haven't spent the time in their head with your new coach, finding out why they're doing it and being there for them and supporting them, what's going to happen? The first person that goes, is this one of them liquid dots? They're going to go, boom! Oh my God. You know what? My grandchild's dog is sick. I can't do this for a couple months. And they're on their way out.
Right.
So you think those are excuses you only get for you. They only go for you if you haven't spent the time on the front end to help your new coach feel rock solid that they have the support, they have the system, and they have it simple enough that they can move forward and do it, right? Failure is the new awesome. Listen, if they wait to make it perfect and they're scared about failing, they're never going to do this business. So you got to make it fun for them. And then face your challenges. You know, I heard a story recently between cows and buffaloes. Anybody know how buffaloes work? Well, cows, apparently in Colorado, near in the plains by the Rocky Mountains, when they see a storm coming, they just can't hang out and keep eating. You know why? Because that's what cows do, right? And that, by the way, it doesn't work out well for them. Unless they're milk cows. They do good. But when the storm comes over the Rockies and comes towards them, they start getting wet, what do? Well, they start going away from the storm, right? They're going away from the storm. I'm not a cow, so I don't even know how to make a cow. Honka! And what happens is, because the storm's coming and they're moving with the storm, what happens? Thus keep getting wet. More the same. Now, a buffalo, on the other hand, buffalo look up, they see the storm, they see it in the distance on the ridge of the Rockies, and they eat that, and then they look, and they see the storm come over, and what do? They charge the storm. They charge right through it. They go right through it, and what happens is what? They minimize their time to the dysfunction. Everything in this business is about that concept. It's about the discipline to meet your challenges and help your new coaches meet those challenges head on. If you meet your challenges head on and develop the discipline on the front end, it happens fast and you're through it and you break through and now you're basically skiing up and down.
Yeah.
How about focus? Focus, you know, we talked about that, but a mirror, basically, a focus can burn a piece of paper. You can take water and focus that energy and go right through steel. You want your new coaches focused on the things that move their business forward, not on organizing their little folders or putting their pens perfect on their desk or reading the habits of health. Yes, that's blasphemy, but I don't want them reading the habits of health in the first week. Hopefully they've done that as a client, but in the first week of the business, I want them getting together, taking their aim and their strategy and going together, and Lori's gonna talk about, and get to seeing your coach right away, right? That's the focus. That's all they need to get going. Don't start teaching them a bunch of other stuff. So here I had to bring this slide up. So, you've seen Animal House, hopefully. How many people have seen Animal House? Okay, so in Animal House, there's a devil on one side and there's an angel, right? And I won't go through the story. Well, I will go through the story. So the angels, the devil starts, the devil's, you know, this. Or 14, 15, he doesn't know it, but the guy in the Animal House, the new pledgee, forgot his name. Anybody know his name? Pinto. Say, God, I knew somebody. Somebody knows that. How do you remember that? Do you know how to move your coach to senior coach? But you know Pinto. So Pinto invites this girl he sees at the checkout line, and he's got her over. She's cute. She's really cute. He doesn't know, but she's like 14 years old, right? So basically, he ends up, you know, goes up, they're in Otter's bedroom. I remember Otter's, so I guess I have time too. Otter's bedroom, and she's sitting there, she's really drinking the punch, you know, he says, yes, I'm in college now, man, I'm becoming a man, and da-da-da, you know the story. And all of a sudden, the devil pops out and says, you know, I can't say what he says, but it's not too good. And all of a sudden, pop, up comes the angel and says, don't you touch a hair on her head. The part you don't really show in anime is the voice of consistency in the middle, which is Pinto's upbringing. Pinto was brought up in a good family, which you didn't know, but I've previously done some investigation on this. And Pinto's parents both brought him up as God-fearing individual, taught him discipline, taught him wrong from right, and certainly taught him that when the girl's 14 years old, you better get her out of here, right? Now that voice of consistency in the middle, that discipline is about as exciting as a dish rag. But it's the thing, it's the daily choices that you have to do to build this business that take all the mundane, the boring part in the middle that you have to discipline yourself to, right? So, let's put it this way. The angel is there about 21% of the time. Crush it, go after this business. And you're feeling that angel is really vibrating inside you, right? Man, let's go crush it, I'm gonna do it. And Mike said, on Monday, what are you gonna do? Well, the angel right now says, we're gonna do this, we're gonna be great, and we're gonna be in fantasy land, we're gonna be on stage next year, right? Right? Then on the other hand, you got the devil. You get home Monday, you're tired, your feet, you go back to work, your boss said, listen, you were gone on Friday, you gotta, here's all the extra work you gotta do. And the devil's going, ha! Angel ain't gonna make anything here. I'm taking over. We're going home. We're kicking up our feet. We're grabbing a beer. We're gonna eat some popcorn and take the night off because we deserve it, right? Well, you can see the devil, because we're designed to have instant rewards, because that was important 10,000 years ago, actually has a higher percent effort. But if you look at the voice of consistency, if you truly have your vision, if you actually have yourself focused on moving yourself in that tape measure that I showed you in the next 5 years, moving from here out to here and changing your trajectory and changing your life, can make all the difference in the world. But you have to do the day in and day out. See, success is only rented. And the rent is due every single day. Every single day. You just don't work because, yeah, of course, yeah, you were at a party and a button flew off and almost killed somebody. He says, that's my sign from God. I gotta get on the program. I gotta do something. And then you go to the gym. And that resolution you made, that commitment you made on New Year's Day, because the football game didn't go your way either, so I said, I gotta change my life. You go to the gym and everybody's there. All of those people that made that one day decision are there, the commitment are there. In March, how many are there? Nobody. It's deciding now and putting yourself and equipping yourself with these tools so that you can, every day, there is an outline for you to move you forward day in and day out, every day. It's about every day getting a little bit better, a little bit more attuned, a little bit more focused, a little bit more into resonance, into the key areas of your trilogy, your physical, your mental, your financial, and working with your coach and making a decision that every day I'm going to do what's necessary. Because you see, if the voice of consistency and the angel get together at 64%+, the devil doesn't have a chance. Right? I talked about most of these, but the bottom line is, I want to go down to the one of master your physiology. See, the reason to really focus on the habits of health and make sure you work on reaching a healthy weight, improving your amount of activity, is all those things dramatically affect the level of your business. If you're rested, if you're not fatigued, you're going to be better in your relationships. You're going to be able to talk to people. You're going to be more alert, more attentive. You're going to feel better. You're going to look better. You're going to be more representative of what we are. If you basically exercise and move more, you're going to feel better, your head's going to be clearer, and you're going to sleep better, and you're going to maintain your weight better. So all these things are interacted. That is why it's a trilogy of interaction. All the pieces of well-being work together, and that's our philosophy. We don't just give you one, we give you all of them, and we work on all of them, and as you build that habit. So here's the deal on habits. Habits are neural pathways that we have. They come together, they create these roads in our brain, and we become on automatic. And 40% of our time, we're on automatic. So what I want you to do in your business habits as a business coach, to work with your new coaches, and also, by the way, you need to learn, because Dan showed you in the blended path, we're starting to build coaches right out of the gate. So you need to learn these things, and you need to learn them to build your business anyway, to take care of your clients, but to take care of your coaches, you need to learn these things. Start focusing on what's the one thing I can do starting today, moving into action, maybe tomorrow, that will accelerate my health, my mental health, and my business the fastest. So I want you to make sure you write down one thing that you can really work on. And then I'm gonna ask you, we're gonna work on it, I'm gonna show you how to do that. And the other piece I want you to do is I want you to focus on one thing that you're going to eliminate in your life right now that will help you work on your physical, mental, and financial health. Because they're related to each other. The one thing you're gonna do and the one thing you're not gonna do. Can you guys do that?
Yes.
That's what, four people?
Yes!
You people at the bar last night, are you going to do it that just came in? Baby, you're taking the escalator. You need to take the stairs. Because once you develop a habit, it takes about a month, and I'm going to show you that. So, pick something that you can do. Don't pick something like, I'm going to run a marathon next month. How much are you running now? Well, I walk from my sofa over to the kitchen. Pick something you can do right now, something that's easy enough that you can do every day. Because what I want, and make it easy enough so you can do it every day, and this is what you want to work with your new coach, and also with your clients, by the way, never miss a day. Make sure, if it's, and I'll use the analogy of the physical things because it's easiest to use as a visual. If you have an exercise machine in your house, and if you're not using it right now, tomorrow morning, grab your coffee, go downstairs, and get on your exercise machine, and drink your coffee. Don't turn it on, for gosh sakes, don't turn it on. But for the next 30 days, can you walk downstairs in the beginning of the morning and get on your exercise machine? Can you do that? Is there anybody that can't do that? Well, if you're in a wheelchair, then pick something else. I'm using, again, these are just ideas. Pick something you can do. For Craig Blanchett, go do a double wheelie, do a flip, whatever it is. But add something that will move your business forward and your health forward. And do it every day. Don't miss a day. Never miss a day. And do it. And then build up. Okay? Now, the next part is definitely never miss 2 days. Because if, let's say, something happened and the world went crazy that one day, the next day, make sure you write down, this is the number one priority. If I don't even eat today, I'm going to do this one thing. You never want to miss 2 days. What do you have to do? You got to start all over again. You understand? That's how your brain works. And if you don't do that, if you think, well, I'm only going to do it 3 days a week, nah, it doesn't work that way. You can't build this business 3 days a week. Even if you only have half an hour a day, you need to use that. And there's three parts of this process. And to think that people, you see them out running, like, God, I wish I loved to jog. Do you realize 2% of people like to exercise? The rest of the people do it because why? Because they're taking the stairs because they know that daily exercise puts them in position to have long-term health, probably makes them more productive at their job, probably makes everything in their life better, right? Yeah. See, it's the small things you do every day that make all the difference. The first phase, that it takes about 30 days to really start this new habit and get it ingrained. First 10 days, it seems impossible. Wow, I don't know if I can get up to that Stairmaster. But I'm there, right? You stand on it, you go, what am I doing here? But you do it every day. The second, it's second to 10 days, or week three, two and a half to three, 10 to 20 days, is harder. But it's not as hard, you can do it. By the last 10 days, you're going, yeah, I can do this. So I want you to start thinking about, in your business habits, of talking to people, working with your coaches, are you building the discipline to pick the high leverage coaches, the ones that want to go, and are you daily working with these people to move them forward, right? Okay, so I talked about arete. Arete is so critical because arete is about becoming everything you can be. And I showed you over time that you've all got a lot of time. I was reassuring Ron that he's living to 120, so he's kind of worried how we're running out of real estate over here. But Ron Gales, who's 75, basically says, no, man, I got all the way to the wall. That's the attitude, and that's how you want to live your life. But the bottom line, if it wasn't so, if what you did today and those little bitty habits that you're adding that don't make a difference today in your business, if you don't add them, and you don't think they matter, and you don't think there is any of this, then just go to the bar or go to Disney World. Just get up right now. Why are you sitting here, right? Because if you're sitting here and you want to grow this business, you need to understand that doing these things, talking to people, you're sowing your seeds to build your business, to harvest those things later. And there, unfortunately, if you do the right thing on Monday when you get back, you're not going to see that harvest on Monday. Right? It's that discipline of setting the things necessary that Lori's going to go over for your brand new coaches, from coach to senior coach, and Terry's going to go over from senior coach to ED, making sure they're doing those things that are necessary. So, basically, one thing to do as a business coach, you want to make sure your new coach is turning them on to all the things, and all this is written, I'm not going to spend any time on it. The key thing is the role as a business coach is to move people forward by guiding them, first to senior coach, which Lori's going to talk about, then on to basically ED and FIBC, on to business building teams of FIBCs, and lastly but not least, becoming a trilogist. That's where the work, that taking the stairs every day, the life that takes discipline and it's harder that you have to do every day now, is going to lead to a life of incredible, amazing, every day, I got to take every day of my life. If my life is taken right now, right this second, I would have a big smile on my face that every day I live my life to the fullest. And I want that for every one of you. And you got to do the work. You got to do the nasty work up here. And you got to do it every day. Okay. So, to finish this up, maybe, here we go. Okay. How do you accelerate? This is what Dan talked about. Terry's going to put a bow on this. But how do you accelerate? It's about duplication. So here's the deal. You gotta keep your new coach focused, just like a toddler, right? If you don't have a toddler, you'll take a fork and stick it in the AC socket, right? You gotta focus on making sure they're doing the safe and the right things. You gotta basically attract and sponsor more people. You need to have them take aim and do their visionary. You need to keep them in their strategy, their tactics, and their action steps. And last but not least, you wanna put them on this business path so that they're learning simultaneously, attracting client and coaches at the same time, because that's how they live the trilogy. That's how they move forward. We want integrated clients and coaches. We want them to progress. So I'm going to end with this. It's like a cookie cutter. If you go to the store, and America's a world of franchises, when you go to McDonald's, and I hope you're not going there, you get the same deal. You go to anywhere in the country, it's the same deal. And we like that because we like safety and comfort. We want to recognize something we feel comfortable. Even though it tastes like caca, and I can say that because I'm a doctor, this stuff tastes like caca. It's like, what are those things? Those are not a chicken. What are those things? Right? What are those things? They don't even taste like it. It's like cardboard. One of the kids, I'm not going to tell you the story, but I sinned. I had one of those big nuggets. And I got to tell you, I felt like Tom Hanks in the, what was it, Big? Wait, I had that nasty taste like that. But the bottom line, you want to become a cookie cutter. You want to first, with your new coach, do it for them. You want to show them how to do it. So what is it? You've got to read this material and incorporate it so you can actually help them do that. Right? You got to stop doing what you're doing and start doing what we're doing. I'm using this stuff. Okay? I've been around longer than anybody. Lori's been around longer than anybody. And we are reading this stuff and using it because we know that the essence of this business is duplication to the pieces. We're not making it about us. We're making it about the system because it isn't about us. It's about us helping other people become successful. And the more we automate that, listen, it's not about your style and technique. We want everybody as entrepreneurs to be supported from the bottom up. But you want to use the materials. I want to do it with them to make sure they're learning it. I want to watch them do it to make sure they duplicate it properly. I want to watch them train their people, and when that happens, I'm going to move them on to the next skill. Because see, what I want this. I want to duplicate myself, transfer those skills, so we can truly make a difference. This mission isn't about me. It's about you. And it's about you picking up on what we're doing and making the difference, right? And if you do that, it happens. Because we want an equity business, we want to live in optimal health. Please, go with this. Let's get America healthy. I love you guys. God bless.